client should. I think that the moon can affect you whether you're outdoors or indoors or whether you can see the moon or not. In any case, we'll know in less than an hour.
As long as we can find Mary before then and explain everything to her.
Well, I still think that Mary is a hallucination brought on by your affliction.
Now, Edsel, you've been treating me for 2 years. Have I had such visions before?
No, but we don't know the course that the disease is going to follow. And try as hard as I might, I haven't been able to find any case studies that resemble yours in any way.
Well, at least Helena's beginning to believe me. She's agreed to do this seance.
Well, I find it very convenient that the housekeeper is the only one who can communicate with the spirits on the other side. I think that her intentions are not as charitable as you would like to believe them.
Well, I do not care about her intentions so long as I can find Mary and explain everything before the full moon.
Welcome, gentlemen.
What are you doing?
I have made the salt circle for the seance.
What?
So the evil spirits will not come inside, they will stay outside.
Mary is not an evil spirit.
Well, but why is she still in our world? Perhaps her intentions are not as charitable as they seem.
Yes, I heard something similar about someone else very recently.
Well, I for one don't see why this seance thing could wait until tomorrow night.
Well, Miss Fielding, trust I have good intention, and I appreciate your indulgence.
I suppose I should be grateful. This is the last night I'll have to spend in this forsaken castle. I cannot wait to get back to London.
Please, ever see this wedding? All of us should see it inside this old circle.
Here you are, old chap. Yeah, thank you, friends.
Please join hands and do not let go, or the spirit connection may be lost.
Spirits of the afterlife, bon appetit. Kumbaya.
We ask you to open the gate betwixt your world and our world. We look for the spirit.
Mary Bloodstone, bring her back here, we need her help. She may find peace if she comes. Please bring her to this room at this time.
Quincey, what is happening?
Mary!
I have never been far from you, but now something is compelling me to walk through the gateway, back to the world of the living.
And walk through it, my love, and prove your existence.
I feel there is a presence in the room.
She here?
She's right there!
But Quincey, old bean, there's no one there!
Mary, show yourself!
Don't leave the circle, she might be a vengeful spirit!
Mary Bloodstone, please, we need your help to get rid of evil! Only you can stop us! It.
Quincey, I can't cross over. There's something blocking my way.
Mary, where are you?
She says something's blocking her way!
I don't know. You're the spiritualist.
Wait, the salt circle!
That's not the salt. It's a wall of lies and secrets. Nobody in this circle is who they claim to be.
That can't be right.
Until your true identities are known to each other, Helena's attempts to manifest me on her plane are doomed to fail.
What does she say, Eva?
She says that everybody's lying about who they are! And that you can't cross over until there's truth within the circle. But I am telling you I'm not lying about who I am. My name is Quincey Abraham Arthur Jack Harker.
Please, use your inside voice for this show.
Oh, I would like to go over the truth.
But you're not Quincey Abraham Arthur Jack Harker. I am.
What? Well, then who am I?
It's all coming back to me. Your name is Teddy. Theodore Van Helsing, son of Abraham Van Helsing, vampire hunter. We haven't seen each other in over 2 years. We grew up together, Teddy, and we followed in the footsteps of our parents. I remember. We traveled to the moors of Scotland on a track to the legendary moon beast. There was a dense fog, and although the full moon was bright, and we carried torches, we couldn't see more than a few feet in front of us. We became separated. There was a horrible growling noise. I heard you call out for help, but before I could get to you, a voice called out to me. It was a beautiful voice, a woman's voice. It was yours!
It is true. I was there as
well, then who are you?
Well, I am not the strange housekeeper. My great name is Lilith Lorelei, like the moon beast that you hunted that night. I come from a family of magical sirens who straddles the world between the natural and supernatural world. My family was destroyed by Count Dracula! Centuries ago, your clubs were instrumental in ridding the world of Dracula, but I sent you from the spirit world that he was coming back and I wanted to enlist your help.
Yes, but why did you stop the beast from attacking me?
Oh, by the time we got there, the fog was so thick, the beast had to win its claws. I had to say, Quincey, he wanted to help you. I sang a song. We ran through the woods. It was a terrible run and you lost your jacket.
Was it a nice jacket?
After that, the next day we went back. Nothing, no body, not a thing. Poor Quincy was so distraught. I gave him a new identity. I told him we were married.
Does this mean you've been manipulating me with your song all along? Is our love and marriage built on deliverance and manipulation?
We can sort out the relationship issues later. Right now, I need to know why. For the past 2 years, I thought that I was Quincy Ingraham Arthur Jack Harker.
I think I can explain that for you. It was traumatic amnesia.
Traumatic amnesia?
Yes, brought on by the attack by the moon beast. Your body was found battered, beaten, almost to death. The only piece of clothing nearby was this nice jacket. And this jacket must have belonged to the original Quincy Abraham Arthur Jack Harker, because in its pockets was a passport and a wallet with that name inscribed. So naturally, the attending physicians thought that that's who you were, that you were this, help me with this name, please, folks.
Quincy Abraham Arthur Jack Harker.
Thank you, that was perfect. Anyway, they summoned me from the Glen Springs Sanitary.
As a representative of a law firm of Shyster, Charlotte, and Ayres, Shem, I must pause here to explain that the Glen Springs Sanitarium mentioned by Edsel is not the Glen Springs Sanitarium of Watkins Glen, New York, but rather an entirely different Glen Springs Sanitarium as seen in Grievous Goings On at the Glen Springs Sanitarium, one of our four shows this season.
Because they knew that I was interested in unusual cases, and your animal bites were most unusual, to say the least.
So, Eddie, does this mean your real name is, Dr. Henry Jekyll?
No. Dr. Jekyll was a fictional character created by that eminent English author, Robert Louis Stevenson. My real name is Bender Falkenstein. I'm a descendant of Victor Frankenstein, creator of a patchwork monster with which I'm sure you are all familiar.
Does that mean you're a mad scientist too?
No, but I become mildly irritated when people assume that mad scientistism is settlement was located in a rather isolated part of upstate New York, which was ideal for me to start up a medical practice and my medical experiments unmolested. Quincey here, Teddy, he volunteered to come to my sanitarium, and because he was an ideal subject for my study, and he hoped that I could cure him of the affliction that he contracted when he was mauled by the moon beast.
So, Eddie, you're German?
Well,
my father fought the Germans in the Great War before he became an estate agent. He would never approve of us.
You can sort out your relationship issues later. Right now, we need to know who you really are and how you're connected to all this.
My name is Teresa Redfield. I really am a lawyer. I'm an estate agent for the law firm of Shyster, Charlatan, and Shep. My father was once under the dread influence of Count Dracula.
Moments ago. I mean, I wasn't even born yet.
Quincey, old bean, you can sort out your relationship.